nobody can shoot, can handle, can defend. IQ.
I believe in World Wide West. I believe in Leon Rose. I'm going to calm down. But my initial reaction, to be honest, is down.
A Woj bomb. We've got a trade. Breaking news coming in. Daryl Morey's wasted no time putting his fingerprints on the Sixers roster. The new Philly GM traded Al Horford and his big contract along with a 2025 first-round pick and a second-round pick, 34th overall, to the Thunder for Danny Green and Terrence Ferguson, according to Adrian Wojnarowski. And there are a lot of things to break down here when you look at this trade, because last offseason, the Sixers made the big storylines, the headlines, by bringing in Horford. Let's bring in Woj right now. Why did the Sixers decide to make this move tonight?
Kevin, brings them back some athleticism, some scoring. Certainly Danny Green, shooting guard who came in to the Thunder from the Lakers. Terrence Ferguson, a young wing. And they get off the remaining 3 years of Al Horford's significant free agent contract. And for the Sixers, this is a chance now, you know, to kind of keep reshaping the pieces around Ben Simmons and Joel Embiid. And for the Thunder, that makes 17 future first-round picks. They are in position. And tonight, three picks in the first and among the top 34.
Yeah, Sam Presti's going to just toss to himself as the draft continues in the next couple of years on draft night here. So what's next here for Daryl Morey and Philly? When they clear up some of this room, they still save some money, a ton of money, next year and the following year. What does this now mean for the roster moves, especially with all the rumors of James Harden?
Well, listen, they're in a position now where they have committed, certainly in the short term, of building around Embiid, building around Simmons, and on Doc Rivers starting to shape a roster that he wants to play with a style he wants to play. And listen, the Sixers, it is unclear whether they're going to be big game hunting in this offseason. It feels right now like they're going to continue to keep trying to find complementary pieces around their two franchise players.
That big game hunting, that was a very famous line last offseason in Philadelphia. We'll see how this plays out. By the way, the busiest thing throughout the entire draft night here at ESPN, Woj's phone. He will let us know and keep us up to date on pending moves and trades. Sage, to you.
Yeah, have that battery charger ready, please, Woj. Here are the details of the trade that Woj just reported. The Sixers, again, adding shooting and Danny Green, while the Thunder continue to add to their treasure chest, do they ever. In addition to Al Horford, the Thunder get another first-round pick. That gives them 17 first-round picks to the 2026 draft. And that way, the rich are certainly getting richer. Stephen A. Smith joins us now live here on SportsCenter. Again, this broke within the last 30 minutes. Stephen A., your reaction to the Horford deal is what?
Well, the first thing that came to my mind is, that, first of all, congratulations to the Philadelphia 76ers, because Al Horford was not the player that he used to be. And as a result, being owed $81 million over the next three seasons guaranteed, you certainly wanted to get out from under that. More importantly than that, though, is the fact that it puts you in a position to really, really go after James Harden if you so choose. Now, we all have heard that he wants to be in Brooklyn. That is his preferred destination. But remember, he played under Daryl Morey for years. They've got a damn good relationship. I've seen it personally. We know what Daryl Morey stands for. He's always in a win-now mode. Clearly, he's not trying to concede the Eastern Conference to Milwaukee, Miami, Boston, Brooklyn, or anybody else. And if you're talking about putting James Harden with a 25-year-old Joel Embiid in the post, you can do some things. Now, obviously, it's going to take a lot to get your hands on James Harden. Ben Simmons would be a way to start, because obviously he's a stud. He can ball. He can't shoot worth a damn. But outside of that, he can do literally everything else on the basketball court for you. So if you're the Houston Rockets and you're thinking about having a future star and you don't necessarily want to capitulate to the demands of James Harden in Brooklyn in a big three scenario with Kevin Durant and Kyrie Irving, you could say the Philadelphia 76ers are giving us more assets than Brooklyn. But also keep in mind the X factor. Tillman Fertitta is not exactly anxious to do Daryl Morey any favors. It's not a truculent relationship or anything like that. I'm just saying, the man used to work for him, got up and left, And a week later, he's the president of basketball operations for the Philadelphia 76ers. So if you're Tillman Fertitta, how anxious are you to help Daryl Morey achieve whatever level of success he aspires for? All of that are interesting components to this particular story.
And that trade, of course, collecting assets. Meanwhile, the Thunder doing that. And we've got more news coming in. According to Woj, Klay Thompson suffered a right leg injury working out in Southern California today and will undergo tests. The severity of the injury is not known. Thompson had been making his way back from an ACL tear in his left leg that he suffered in the 2019 finals and cost him all of last season. Let's bring in Adrian Wojnarowski with much more on this story. What more can you tell us, Woj, about this injury?
Kevin, Klay Thompson was working out in Southern California today when he suffered what was described to me as a lower right leg injury, and he's going to undergo tests here the next few days. I'm told it is immediately unclear the severity of the injury. Now, it was his left ACL that he missed all of the 2019 and 2020 season, the injury he had suffered in the previous NBA Finals. But right now, they're still waiting to get a sense of how serious this injury might be, Kevin.
Well, it's the big story. Of course, the Timberwolves are on the clock in a draft that is really unknown in the top three. The Warriors pick number two. How could this injury impact what the Warriors do tonight?
I think it's too early to tell, Kevin. They don't know what they have, certainly with this injury with Klay Thompson. But certainly understand when you're drafting a teenager at the top of the draft, it's a long view. Not based off an injury in the short term, but listen, if they're very serious about LaMelo Ball at two, if he's there, James Wiseman, they were still working through those today. So remains to be seen how it's going to impact him tonight in the draft.
Okay, Woj from the draft room as we get ready for the NBA virtual draft right here on the campus at ESPN. Let's go to Sage.
Again, Woj is keeping track of breaking news from all different angles here with us on SportsCenter. He's standing by if need be. Also standing by now live is our Stephen A. Smith. And Stephen A., less than an hour ago, you and I were here on SportsCenter talking about what the Warriors should do with that number two overall pick. We're talking about the big man, James Wiseman, and how great of a fit he'd be with a healthy Klay Thompson, Steph Curry, Draymond Green. As Woj said, you heard him. We don't know that much right now, but your first reaction when you hear an injury to a leg of Klay Thompson, what do you say?
This is nightmarish.
Yeah.
This is nightmarish. All championship hopes are out the window. You need both. You can't have Klay without Steph. You can't have Steph without Klay and talk championship. You can talk playoffs. You can talk excitement. You can talk box office appeal. But you can't talk championship having one without the other. You need both of them. This is the greatest shooting backcourt we have ever seen in the history of basketball. Do you know that Klay Thompson has never shot less than 40% from three-point range in his career? Ever! That's who we're talking about here. We constantly talk about the two-time MVP, that is Steph Curry. We constantly recognize him because he can shoot off the dribble, not just standing still with a setup shot. It's off the dribble. He can create his own shot better than Klay Thompson. We constantly call him the greatest shooter ever. Let's understand something. His backcourt mate, Klay Thompson, is one of the top five shooters in the history of basketball. I don't care what anybody says. Reggie Miller, Ray Allen, Allen Houston, downtown Freddie Brown from the Seattle Supersonics in the 70s, for crying out loud. Ricky Pierce, Dale Ellis, Del Curry. I don't give a damn what shooter you find. Klay Thompson is one of the top five shooters in the history of basketball. And for this man